This skeleton is the primary structure of a space vehicle called Dream Chaser. Today, it's one step closer to reality.
We've been waiting for this moment for a long time.
At their headquarters in Louisville, Colorado, Sierra Nevada Corporation revealed their progress in what they call America's space plane. The bones of Dream Chaser are a composite material of carbon fiber polymers, more advanced than the metal alloys in the spaceships of the past, stitched together by Lockheed Martin.
But if you glue everything together within tolerances of a fraction of an inch, it's truly an amazing engineering marvel.
Sierra Nevada will now finish the construction right down to the black and white heat shield. Dream Chaser's first six trips to space will be non-crewed cargo and science missions to the International Space Station.
Space Station was really designed around the space shuttle.
Former NASA astronaut and shuttle commander Steve Lindsay says the shuttle-like design serves that purpose. For example, he says the science conducted on the ISS is best served with the low G and gentle re-entry to Earth, so there's less strain on the experiments.
When the space shuttle program was retired, we lost some of that ability.
The ISS program manager says it's often critical that the research gets home to scientists quickly. He cited the recent loss of a blood-related experiment that returned to Earth on a Soyuz capsule, landing in a remote part of Kazakhstan.
We went through multiple airlines, multiple airports, and cross-country cab rides to get the samples home, and we missed it by about 5 hours.
The Dream Chaser will land on a runway like the shuttle, and the science can be in the lab in a matter of minutes.
I think we've got a wonderful capability. I do think we're going to change the world.
In Louisville, meteorologist Corey Reppenhagen, 9 News.
And 400 of the 600 employees that are working on Dream Chaser are here in Colorado. It will be launching to space on a Vulcan rocket built by Colorado-based United Launch Alliance.